Welcome everybody to module 7 of our bio-based MOOC. I'm Katrin Kriebs and I'm a project manager of the Cluster Industrial Biotechnology coordinating this MOOC. Today I'm visiting Harry Bitte from Wageningen University and Research, and we are going to talk about the development in bioeconomy and his opinion on this. Welcome.
Thank you. Welcome in Wageningen, Katrin.
Thanks. So a lot of effort is in progress on bioeconomy, yeah, on sustainable economy. What do you think was the first big step that happened?
Yeah. Well, interesting question. I think this is difficult to answer. But we should not forget that bio-based economy is actually not new. We are addicted to fuel and fossil resources for the last, let's say, 150 years. But before that, we used bio-based resources as food, as building materials, also to heat. We burn part of it. So it's not new. But of course, I agree that in the last years, there are all kinds of exciting developments. And I would say a few clear examples is, for example, polylactic acid, which is a bio-based polymer. It's biodegradable under certain conditions. I think that is one of the big steps and one of the first steps where we really show that bio-based economy can work. But of course, sugar-based materials and sugar-based food was also there before. So I personally don't think there is one clear moment where the bio-based economy started.
Do you think the bioeconomy can replace the fossil-based industries completely? And to what extent can we do that within the next 10 years?
Yeah, that's a very interesting and difficult to answer question, I think. Well, technically, I would say a lot is possible, right? But you have to keep a few things in mind. The fossil industry is in volume is very big, especially when you look to fuels. We use nowadays about 90 million barrels of oil per day. About 80 to 90% goes to fuel. So that's a lot. But there are, of course, technical developments and new feedstocks to replace the fossil resources and go to fuels, materials and chemicals. I'm not so sure about the fuels, not about diesel and petrol. Can we replace that all? Maybe we have to look there into other alternatives. But certainly for materials and chemicals, there is a big potential for bio-based resources.
Thanks for that insight. What do you think might be a next step in the area of materials and chemicals?
Well, I think one of the big challenges at the moment still is in general, and I generalize here, I emphasize that, bio-based products, chemicals, materials, are still a bit more expensive than fossil resources. And the fossil industry, fossil-based industry, is very, very efficient. With bio-based feedstocks, we need new conversions. We need to learn how to work with these new feedstocks. And I think that is still one of the big challenges, how to make this economically viable. Or there should be another driver to do it, because at the moment, it's still a little bit more expensive. But maybe you want to do it from, let's say, sustainability point of view. It's better for the environment. And if we are willing to pay for that, we can do it.
That's a big problem. What can each and every one of us do to promote a sustainable bioeconomy then?
Well, I think that depends on your area, right? I mean, I'm a chemist. I like to do conversions. I like to make one molecule out of the other. And that we need to do more efficient. We have more challenges. Bio-based feedstocks are a bit more challenging for us nowadays compared to fossil-based feedstocks, so there's a challenge for us to make the processes, for us, me, to make these processes more efficient. But also, we have to look at consumers. How do they respond to these new products? Maybe a little bit more expensive. Can we convince them, and how to convince them, to use these new materials? We also have to look at feedstocks. Which bio-based feedstocks are we actually going to use? We see algae, we see waste, we see plants, we see other kinds of waste streams. What are we going to use? So I think depending on your area, we can all contribute to that. And that's also a little bit what you hopefully saw in this MOOC, that you have to look at it from different perspectives.
Yes, I think we all agree on that we have to change something in the next stage. Where do you think the main responsibility lies? Is it the customers? Is it the industry? Or is it the governments that need to push?
Yeah, this is a difficult question. And also, I have to admit, outside my personal area, as I said, I'm a chemist. But the main driver, or maybe there are two main drivers. You can look from a consumer point of view. If we want to buy these materials, then certainly somebody will supply it. If that doesn't happen, maybe governments and legislation has to help a little bit. And yeah, this is a little bit the challenge at the moment. And the consumers are maybe willing, but not convinced yet. The governments are also a little bit in the same problem. Are we going to push certain feedstocks or certain approaches or not? So it's still a challenging time at the moment. But yeah, at the end, it's the consumers who have to do something, or to buy the materials, to use the materials. So they have a big role, I think.
Thanks for these insights, Harry. Yes, we are on a good way, but still not there. Thank you for your attention and see you next time.